These three lights are extremely similar. Quad Nichia 519As, linear plus FET drivers, Anduril 2, and auxiliary lights. With very close pricing, can any one of these 21700 hot rods stand above the rest? Let's start with the Emisar D4K. Aside from the extra power provided by the larger battery, it shares all features and options with the older D4V2, which I've already reviewed. The only significant new feature here is this micro arc oxidizing, which creates a thick, chalky white finish that looks awesome and is slightly tougher than the standard hard anodizing. Supposedly anyways, it does cost a few dollars more, but is a really nice option in my opinion. Honestly, this light is fantastic. It's as good as Emisars have always been, and my only complaint is that the D4V2 is now a separate model. I do think Hank should have just killed that light altogether, and then offered an 18650 tube for this light, then rolled that change out to all the other smaller Emisars. As it stands though, the smaller light is smaller, and technically more carryable, but the difference is actually very minor, and the D4K is superior in terms of performance as a result. The Fireflies PL09 Quad is very similar in design to the D4K, with the only meaningful difference really being the metal button and single color auxiliaries. The optic is a custom design and is a bit throwier than the car clone the Emisar. This is basically the prettier version of the D4K. The dedicated Mule version of this light is a little more unique, offering auxiliaries and 9 E21A emitters with a linear driver. The Wurkkos TS25 is the largest and cheapest of these lights, and is the only one that offers USB-C charging and power bank functionality. It's got a throwier beam and includes a battery, which may make this the most practical option for a lot of people, and it's an excellent value. All three lights utilize very similar linear plus FET drivers that provide super high output on turbo. However, slight differences in components and optics result in a very real change in the actual output that they can provide even with the same cell. The D4K has a much thicker battery tube than the others, uses high-quality beryllium copper springs, and has the clearest optics of the bunch. The Fireflies PL09 makes use of a soldered spring bypass in the head. While running off a very powerful Mollus LP42A, the Emisar manages a really impressive 5,200 lumens. The Wurkkos TS25 puts out the lowest output at 3,500 lumens, and the Fireflies sits right in the middle with about 4,500 lumens on turbo. None of these lights, though, are designed for high sustained outputs, and all quickly drop from turbo to settle around the same brightness. During the initial drop from turbo, the hierarchy flips, with the D4K falling the fastest and the TS25 holding the most light, while all end up settling at about a minute into the run. Here, the PL09 pulls ahead, sustaining about 350 lumens, while the TS25 still lags about 100 lumens behind. Another interesting quirk is the output spacing in the ramp. While both the D4K and TS25 are very smooth and even, very nice, the PL09 has a really uneven ramp, and is especially bad at the lowest few levels, which annoyingly results in poor mode spacing on stepped ramping mode. It's not super apparent on this graph I attempted to put together, but in person it is quite noticeable, and I do find it to be a nuisance. Now, these output numbers don't tell the whole story, and things get a bit more interesting when looking at intensity. All three of these lights are equipped with 5000K Nichia 519A LEDs, which produce a very neutral and floody high CRI beam. The Emisar D4K's Carclo quad optic is the floodiest, while the Wurkkos TS25 has a much tighter custom optic that is surprisingly throwy, and the Fireflies once again sits in the middle. The Wurkkos is superior at medium to long range, and has the best beam overall in my opinion, with a clean hotspot, wide spill, and no visible artifacts. The D4K also has a nice pattern, but there is noticeable tint shifting and faint artifacts in the spill, while the PL09 has much more noticeable artifacts, and even some chromatic aberration in the spill. Again though, overall, they're all very good. As an all-around LED, the 519A is hard to beat with both high output and great color rendering. Emisar and Fireflies offer these emitters in a range of temperatures, with or without domes, while currently Wurkkos only has this 5000K option available, though I'm sure they'll offer more in the future. The Wurkkos is the largest and also the cheapest, which is reflected in its build quality. I wish a stainless steel bezel was provided here, but for the price, the build is decent. The other two lights are physically very similar, but I do find the Emisar to be a bit more refined, with smoother edges and a better feel in the hand. That said, I really like the look of the PL09, and I especially love the large metal button, which feels great to use. On the flip side, the Fireflies has the worst O-rings ever. They're crap. They always want to get caught and destroyed in the threads. They're very annoying. In spite of that, the PL09 is actually the only light of the bunch to carry a full IPX8 rating, and it does have a slightly tougher anodizing. I just wish a couple of the edges were softened up a bit. That would make it my favorite of the bunch. It does annoy me that the Quad still has the Mule label, and also I ordered the red anodizing and I got blue instead. But at least it's a very nice blue color. All three have magnets in the tail cap, but the TS25 magnet is a bit weak for its size. The D4K and TS25 have RGB auxiliaries, while the PL09 has single color aux lights. Though less versatile, these monochrome emitters produce nicer secondary colors than the RGB LEDs, and I just prefer the way they're arranged under the optic. It's also worth noting that the Mule version is one of the only Mules you can currently buy that has auxiliaries, which is super cool. Practically, I think the most important difference here is the button design. The D4K probably has the best design, the recess button probably won't turn on in your pocket, the PL09 might, and the TS25 probably will, the button is very prominent. All are easy to find in the dark and have backlights, and all are nice to use. The TS25 occasionally misses my inputs, but that seems to be a firmware issue on my particular model. These lights run Toykeeper's Anduril 2, with all the awesome features that entails. The D4K uses the same MCU and flashing pads as the other Emisars, while the PL09 has flashing pads with a different pinout. The TS25 I have is an early run version with some bugs and wonky aux LEDs, but the updated model has all the same Anduril and aux features as the others, and it features flashing pads as well. It's really awesome to see all three of these having easy firmware reflashability. There is one major advantage for the Emisar. Options. The D4K has a ridiculous amount of customizability, with choices for anodization, battery tubes, tons of emitters, different optics, switch color options, and three driver types to choose from. This light will also be available in a titanium version, which maybe even means copper and brass versions in the future as well. Between all these choices and its use of Emisar's standardized flashing pad system, this is still just the best light for enthusiasts, and one that will, I think, deservedly be very popular. The Fireflies PL09 is a really good light, and I honestly prefer it just for the design and the slightly throwier beam. It too has plenty of emitter options, several different battery tube choices, including a tube for longer cells with USB-C charging ports, the option for different auxiliary LED colors, and there is an awesome Mule version available. I really like the Mule version, we'll talk about it more in another video. However, overall, it lacks some refinement compared to the Emisar, and I don't know if I can quite recommend it over the D4K as it comes in at a very similar price. The Wurkkos TS25 is the most unique option, and is quite compelling for its great value and built-in charging port. I also like this beam the most, it's just the cleanest and the most useful. However, it's a bit larger and less carryable, and the button is very easy to accidentally press in a pocket, yet a little more difficult to find in the dark than the other two. Despite that, this is yet another great high-value light from Wurkkos. And between the price and the extra features, this is probably the light I recommend the most out of this bunch, at least to people new to the hobby. Well, this TS25 was sent to me for review by Wurkkos directly, and the D4K was sent to me by Jackson Lee of JLHawaii808.com, who also swapped out the emitters to the 5000K 519As, which are not available directly from Hank. I purchased the PL09 myself for this video, and will link everything down below. I really enjoy all three of these lights, it's hard for me to pick a favorite. However, if I was going to carry and recommend a 21700 sized Anduril light, my top choice is still actually the Wurkkos TS21. It's just the most carryable and has the throwiest beam, which works better for me. An Anduril triple with high CRI SST20s, it's a killer value at $35. You can watch my review of the light here.